But getting back to Dr. Jackson and understanding the continuity of history, I would say that the thing that I think makes her leadership important in the civil rights movement in Baltimore is that she made this a religion all unto itself, this whole matter of civil rights. That wherever it was necessary for us to have a spokesman, she was that person, our spokesperson. And wherever she felt the necessity for making some kind of an appeal for equal rights and justice under the law, she did it. And many times at a personal sacrifice. Naturally, later on, the NAACP started getting funds from the churches, and so they were undergirded by church funds and that kind of a thing right along. But even then, she had to have the personal magnetism and persuasion to get churchmen to give and to support. I used to always enjoy her coming to a large church meeting and just having her personality take over. You know, everybody any presiding officer would always use as a measure of his success to preside, his ability to keep her down to limit her to 2 minutes or 3 minutes. And she would come in with a glimmering eye and look at him and say, "Young man, he could be 60, 70 years old. Young man, you just got here. I've been here in this struggle for all these years." And then she'd go on to push him aside with a verbal barrage that would just reduce him to nothing, and then go on to make her appeal. And it would always last 15, 20 minutes. But people would...